Thank you
please,
very much.
Time, yeah?
Yes.
Thank you.
I think the way to go is to really examine ourselves. The 3.5% of our budget that was spent on health, what did it buy for us? We don't know. That is the basic question.
So even the money being spent?
Yes, we don't know, because a couple of people on the panel had mentioned accountability, transparency. These are related to the fact that what proportion of that 3.5% went into primary health care? What proportion went into secondary? What proportion went into tertiary?
So
if we know how much we have spent, and we know what we have spent the money for, because from my own background, if a man is not cannot be trusted with a little, he cannot be trusted with much.
Okay, so in terms of just while I'm waiting, let me just ask a quick question. Are we wanting to speak to people at the local government, perhaps on the state level, to say they should start actively tracking the way the money is being spent?
Certainly.
So that's one solution.
Yes.
Active tracking of resources.
Follow the money.
Who will do the tracking?
Oh, the people. I mean, they can be empowered to do that.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this is one of the suggestions.
Yes.
Get people to begin to ask elected officials.
Questions from the elected officials.
Okay.
We need to prioritize health in this country.
Right. I'll come back to you because you don't have a mic. But let me let the young lady who's got the mic speak. Yeah,
okay, sure. Good evening, everyone. My name is Hawa Abbas. I represent Silver Lining for the Need Initiative. So I'm coming from the human aspect, not the monetary issues. Like Ruby said, when you get to the health facility, there are no health personnel there. Mm-hmm. And those that are there, their attitudes drive away the people who they're trying to serve. So what is the plan to make sure that, I mean, we have a lot of human resources, and we have a lot of people, NGOs. We have lots of NGOs in Nigeria. What is the plan to get NGOs to also be part of this process in the community level? That's what I want to understand, because I see a lot of NGOs, a few doing work, but it's like they're working alone. We're not working together. So how do we make sure that we're working together so everything is recorded on one track?
Okay. So let me see if I can quickly summarize. We've agreed we probably need more resources, and then we need to, you know, account for the ones that we already are spending. And now there's talk of maybe training for personnel, making sure that you work in partnership. Is this part of what you're trying to do?
This is exactly what we're trying to do at MPACDA. You know, when you look at all the challenges that we face with primary health care, these points that have been made so far are exactly the right issues that we need to address. The issues around availability of the human resources that are well trained, right? The issue of accountability, right? So one of the reasons why we're able to push polio to almost eradication is because we help people accountable. For the very first time in Nigeria, there was a clear accountability
with that
system.
That polio campaign,
right?
Was it primarily driven by government, or did you end up getting a lot of help from donors, and that's why you were successful?
Well, the donor aspect is again around the funds that they provide, right? Mm-hmm. But in terms of asking people, you know, you are supposed to give vaccinations in rural areas, and then the report comes back that you did not go there. Mm-hmm. What happened, right? It was only when traditional leaders started asking questions, right? We engaged traditional leaders, and then they took responsibility for the programs and said that you will not take part in the program ever again because you did not do your work.
Okay.
But so in so many instances, like the lady mentioned, you go to a health facility, right? And the health worker doesn't treat you nice, doesn't treat you with respect, doesn't treat you with dignity. And that health worker continues to work. Nobody is asking her tough questions around how she's managing the health facility. Mm. Those are issues that we're trying to address, right? So for instance, with the Basic Healthcare Provision Fund, I hope that the National Assembly will appropriate it in the 2018 budget, right? Part of the money that comes to Primary Healthcare Development Agency will go directly to the health facility. So it removes all those bottlenecks. Mm. So it removes the opportunity for people to line their pockets at federal, at state level, or at the LGA level. It goes to the health facility. And at the health facility, the health worker can buy drugs, buy commodities, and fix the roof if the roof is leaking, can paint the wall if the health facility doesn't look good enough. So the person in charge of a health center is not just somebody who treats you for malaria, but somebody who is the chief executive officer of that health facility.
Takes personal responsibility
absolutely.
For everything.
So there's that financial
happens.
And that management autonomy that we're trying to bring about with primary health care.
Yes, Mr. Emmanuel.
Just a few. I think the trajectory is very positive and very encouraging because there are a lot of organizations now that are building coalitions of civil societies to ensure that the communities are well sensitized and empowered to ask for services, empowered to follow the money that is put to them, empowered to ask government of their service compact with people, advocate to ask government, you made this law, you made this guideline, you made this policy, how far? And I think that's very good. This is one of the ways we...
I keep hearing, though, this word, urgency.
Yeah.
And I keep hearing people talk about things that have started, but nobody's talking about timelines within which things must happen, otherwise...
You
seem to say something.
That's the problem with this country. We have a lot of wonderful policies. You know, the government came up with CHIPS, CHU, Junior CHIPS, MSS. These are programs that were put in place to solve most of these health problems. But it will start very well, they will pilot it, they will launch it. Go after a few months to that location. It's dead. It is not sustained, it is not implemented, and there is nobody to ask. The MSS, when it came out, they brought even retired nurses to go to work in communities. I visited some local governments at that time. The nurse or the matron came once for 2 months. Her stipends were stopped, and then she left. And that was how that wonderful program died down. The same with CHIPS. I understand it as they have brought it back. It had another name then. You know, community ward something, whereby the community themselves go into the villages to come and call people and educate them and sensitize them to go to the health facilities. It started very well. People were, you know, they were clamoring for health care. There was a lot of people at the health care centers. After a while, the whole thing died.
I'm going to have to stop you there because I have to go for a quick break. Don't go away.